you see here, a round table, and the media members, Chris McManus from the WAER Talk staff, and Tyler Dunne, a football beat writer for the Daily Orange. And guys, looking back at this past week game against Pittsburgh, not a win, the effort was there, but what do you take away from it?
I mean, it's kind of hard to take anything away from it, David. I mean, I think it's a game that a lot of people expected to turn out that way. You know, I was on the radio beforehand, thought they'd lose by 4 touchdowns, and, you know, they almost did. I think, you know, the one positive that you take is that DeLon Carter's been running hard all season, and for once it actually showed up in the stat column. Other than that, you know, I don't think there was really anything that people didn't expect down there in Pittsburgh.
I mean, it was the season in a nutshell. You know, the offense, you know, the one back-breaking turnover just kills them. The defense kept it close for a while, like they have in many games this year. Then one interception, one fumble, it just kills this team. That Paulus interception before the half just really set the team back.
You talk about the offense not getting it done. Greg Paulus, Ryan Nassib, both are playing because Coach Merlin feels like that's the best way to win football games. It's not working for the Orange right now. Where do you go from here in terms of the quarterback situation?
I mean, I think it's time that, you know, it was time 3-4 weeks ago to put Ryan Nassib in my opinion. I think that at some point this year, right, the Greg Paulus experiment was the right move. You had to do it. It was worth a shot. But at some point, Ryan Nassib had to be the starter. You have to find out if he's the guy for the future. And Greg Paulus, I mean, this is a one-year fling.
I mean, I'm in the minority here. I want to see Greg Paulus get a chance to play some of the weaker teams in the Big East. You know, we've seen him against the four toughest teams. To me, he hasn't lost a game yet that the Syracuse team should have won. You know, he beat Maine, he beat Akron, and he won a game that they maybe shouldn't have won against Northwestern. So to me, Greg Paulus is your starter unless he loses this one at Louisville that they should win.
You talk about the schedule. Louisville, Rutgers, UConn, the bottom tier along with Syracuse in the Big East. And unfortunately for the Orange, they had to play all the top teams to start off. So the losses are really piling up. Just 3 wins on the year, 3 more to get to a bowl game. Chris, how many wins do you think Syracuse is going
to
get?
You know, I think they're lucky to get one at this point. With after 21 players have left, after you lose your clear 2 best players in Art Jones and Mike Williams, to me there's really only 2 guys left on this team that you really want to be starting on a bowl team: Darrell Smith and DeLon Carter. So to me, if they get this win against Louisville and exceed their total from last year, I think that's a moral victory in itself.
Yeah, I think they beat Louisville, and I 4 wins, it might not seem like much of an improvement, but Doug Marrone, he's tearing down the team before he builds it up. You know, guys are quitting, guys are getting suspended. He really wants to get his own recruits in there to move forward, so this is kind of the year that you get with that.
The final stretch for the Syracuse Orange, and we'll be covering it here on the Media Roundtable.